In this video, we'll be discussing the brig Kentucky. Originally built for peaceful trade, the Kentucky was later converted into a vessel used to capture and enslave peoples of Africa. By discussing this complicated history, we can acknowledge interconnections between Penobscot Bay history, commodification, and the complexities of African enslavement in the 1800s. The Kentucky was built in Searsport, Maine by John A. Carver in 1833. He intended for it to be one of the fastest sailing brigs in the world. It was fully rigged, 223 gross tons, and 94 feet long. It was built for John Carver's brother, Benjamin Carver, who served as the ship's captain. There is evidence he made trips down the East Coast to the Caribbean and South America, returning with sugar and molasses. Once, while at sea, the Kentucky was chased by an English man of war under the impression she was a slaver bound to Rio de Janeiro. When he hove to, the English captain boarded the Kentucky and remarked he likely never would have been able to catch her had she not stopped. Benjamin Carver served as captain for the Kentucky for 10 to 12 years, continuing his career on different vessels after the Kentucky was sold to a New York firm. Though it isn't clear who specifically initiated the sale, the Kentucky was sold to Manuel Pinto de Fonseca, a Portuguese nobleman, sometime between 1843 and 1845. According to testimonial accounts, it was sold with the intention to become a slaver ship. Under American colors, papers, and crew, it traveled to Brazil and then to Africa. An American from Philadelphia named Captain George Douglas hand-delivered the vessel to the East African coast, where a Brazilian crew was waiting to take over the ship. The American crew then disembarked and boarded another vessel, the Porpoise, which would take them back across the Atlantic. This was a process facilitated many times by Captain Libby of the Porpoise and Captain Paulo, one of Fonseca's agents. The Kentucky, then under a Brazilian crew, built an additional deck for storage, captured as many as 650 Africans, and chained them together before forcing them below deck. While returning back to Rio, there was one failed uprising incited by the enslaved peoples, which resulted in 46 being murdered. Once they arrived back to Rio, a crew member departed and reported the activity to the Brazilian government. Several individuals were tried for their crimes. The Kentucky was reportedly burned off the east coast of Africa by a British man of war. A meaningful quote from executive papers of the ambassador of the United States to Brazil, Mr. Henry A. Wise, effectively summarizes the role of American mariners in the trade and enslavement of Africans in the 1800s. In a letter he wrote, dated February 18, 1845, Mr. Wise said, "It would seem, at first, the United States have nothing to do, but an intimate and full knowledge of the subject informs us that the only effectual mode of carrying on that trade between Africa and Brazil at present involves our laws and our moral responsibilities as directly and fully as it does those of this country itself. Our flag alone gives the requisite protection against the right of visit, search, and seizure, and our citizens in all the characters of owners, of co-signees, of agents, and of masters and crews of our vessels are concerned in the business and partake of the profits of the African slave trade, to and from the ports of Brazil, as fully as Brazilians themselves and others in conjunction with whom they carry on. In fact, without the aid of our citizens and our flag, it would not be carried on with success at all."